Tattoos have been important for millennia. Utzi, the Iceman whose remains were found in the Alps in 1991, had a total of 61 tattoos covering his body. These tattoos were thought to be intended for pain relief, and he lived somewhere around 5,300 years ago. This picture is a mock-up of what he likely looked like when he was alive. Today, most tattoo inks contain metals and liquids like glycerin or alcohol. Historically, however, and in some modern-day tattoos, pigments are plant-based. So today, I'm going to talk about a few examples of plant-based tattoo pigments. Utzi's tattoos, which I mentioned, are classified as soot tattoos. That soot, however, likely came from rocks and not plants, but many soot tattoos did use plants to create that pigment. An example of this is traditional tattoos in Samoa. Male tattoos are called malofi, and female tattoos are called malu. I apologize if I'm completely butchering the pronunciation on those. As a group, those tattoos are known as tatau. There's some speculation that the word tattoo was derived from that word. These are highly intricate pieces, generally covering the person from the waist down. For men, getting them is considered a rite of passage. They're considered courageous for getting them, and they're also a sign of manhood. They are also considered a rite of passage for women, but they're generally less extensive and more decorative and less societally significant. Historically, these tattoos were done with soot from the candlenut tree, Alarides malacanus. The fruit or candle nut of that tree is burned down into soot, and that ash is then used as the tattoo pigment. These tattoos are still done today and are culturally significant. Some of the sources I found said that they sometimes use modern day tattoo inks or candle nut soot. Another example of plant-based tattoo pigments is the alleged use of woad by the Picts. Woad, statis tinctoria, has been used for centuries as a blue dye. You may have heard that the Picts used woad to create intricate blue tattoos to intimidate their enemies in battle. In fact, the word Pict comes from the supposed tattooing, meaning the painted ones, at least according to some sources. There is much debate, however, as to how true this is. It may be the result of translations or stories passed down and watered down, because studies have found that woad doesn't really make a good temporary or permanent tattoo pigment. Tattoos were also present in ancient Rome. In fact, we still have the recipe from a physician in ancient Rome, which included Egyptian pine bark, corroded bronze, vinegar, iron sulfate, and insect galls. This mixture was then rubbed into cuts to produce permanent tattoos. All of these techniques, however, produce permanent tattoos. There are, however, plant pigments that are used to create temporary patterns on the skin, and you may have heard of this first one, which is henna. Henna is derived from the plant Lawsonia inermis, and it grows natively in Asia, Africa, and parts of Australasia. The pigment used in these tattoos comes from the leaves, which are dried and ground down into a brown powder. The tradition of using this pigment to stain the skin is known as mendi and has been around for thousands of years. These patterns made with henna are often associated with special occasions, holidays, weddings, that sort of thing. Henna is also popular around the world as a component of hair dyes and hair care, because in addition to producing pigment, it is very, very softening. My hair is actually dyed with henna. Another form of temporary tattoo is jagua, using the Janipa plant, which is also known as jagua. The juice of its fruit creates a temporary black stain on the skin, and it's native to South America as well as some subtropical areas of Latin America. It's used by people in those areas medicinally and in food, but most importantly, to dye the skin, as you can see on these folks right here. Now, this was only a sampling of the many cultures that use plant pigments as a dye and as tattoos. If you know any more, please tell me about them in the comments. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you learned a little about ancient and current day methods of body art using plant-based pigments. I also want to extend a massive thank you to the Vlog Brothers for sponsoring this video through their scholarship program. I've so far been able to get a new light, which you may notice that I'll be playing around with. I'll also be getting Final Cut Pro, which will be an interesting learning experience. And as always, I want to thank my Patreon supporters and all of the folks who are just watching. Without you, I wouldn't be making these videos. You can hit the like button and subscribe, which would be super helpful, and I will see you soon.